PBS Kids opens worlds of possibilities for all children, thanks to PBS stations and viewers like you.
Martha was an average dog. She went and. But when she ate some alphabet soup, then what happened was bizarre.
On the way to Martha's stomach, the letters lost their way. They traveled to her brain, and now
she's got a lot to say. Now she speaks.
How now, brown cow?
Martha speaks. Yeah, she speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks.
What's a caboose? What are we eating again?
Martha speaks.
Hey, Joe, what do you know?
My name's not Joe.
She's not always right, but still that Martha speaks.
Hi there.
She's got her voice, she's ready to shout. Martha will tell you what it's all about. Sometimes wrong, but seldom in doubt. Martha will tell you what it's all about. That dog's unique.
Testing, 1, 2.
Hear her speak. Martha speaks and speaks and speaks and speaks and
communicates, enumerates, elucidates, exaggerates, indicates and explicates, bloviates and overstates and hyperventilates.
Martha, to reiterate, Martha speaks.
Lanky, scrawny, swift as a bird.
We've got the best words you've ever heard.
Stamina, endurance, dexterity. We are going to...
What rhymes with dexterity?
Hey there. We're cheering for today's words. So listen to them all, and we'll see you at the end of the show.
I've got it. We'll improve your vocabulary.
Yeah. We'll work on it.
Thunder, there's not a cloud in the...
It's coming from Truman's. Maybe he blew up his chemistry set again.
No, we've been invaded.
Invaded? By aliens?
No, by Stanley. He's my cousin.
Ooh, more food. Hello, new favorite person.
Hey, talking dog. Yeah, cool. There's been a couple movies about that.
Really? Tell me more.
Hurry up, True.
Man, True Man. It's not as if my name is multisyllabic. There are only two.
Come on, man.
Ah, there's the second syllable. Now if you could only put them together.
You're missing the best part.
No, I'm not. It's so loud I can practically see it.
Oh, come on, Cars. You gotta blast it if you wanna get the full effect.
Is that the big break-in?
Yeah. Did you see it?
No, but I saw the even bigger break-in and the biggest break-in ever.
Stanley's obsessed with movies. He can tell you the plot of almost any movie there is.
Really?
Uh-huh. He comes to town once a year with my aunt and uncle. They're all staying at the hotel. Ooh! They kick Stanley out on account of the TV being so loud.
The hotel management?
No, my aunt and uncle.
Gah! No! This is as noisy as a turbo-powered cat! With a jackhammer! Falling downstairs! At a rock concert! What'd she say?
Something about cats!
That was great!
My ears are still ringing!
Relax, True.
Halfway there. Can he finish it?
I have just what the doctor ordered.
The rest of my name?
What? No, man.
There it is.
The sequel. It's up in my room.
Huh. Hey, watch it, bub.
Excuse me, young man.
Pardon me? Have we met somewhere before?
Martha, you shouldn't startle people like that.
There's something familiar about those two. I feel like I've sniffed them somewhere before.
Maybe they wear perfume like Grandma's.
Nope.
They shop at Carl's?
Nuh-uh.
They use the same laundry detergent as us?
No, sir. Great gobs of goulash! Those are no ladies! That was the world-famous jewel thief, Louis Kablooey, and his accomplice, Jimmy Gimme Moore.
Oh, wow. Crooks?
No way!
Way? Yes, way. I'd know that smell anywhere.
Martha's right. Those two are way too burly to be women.
Yeah, and they're big and strong, too.
Well, that's what burly means, that someone is big and strong. like wrestlers. Wrestlers are burly. Our football players, those are super burly.
But why would two world famous and burly thieves vacation in Wagstaff City in dresses? Huh?
Because they're not on vacation, and their next job is right here.
They're trying to rob the jewelry store again.
I know exactly how they're going to do it. I saw it in this movie, The Big Drill. What happened was, these guys robbed a jewelry store by getting a hotel room, then drilling right through the wall and into the vault.
Didn't anyone hear them?
That's the trick. They waited until there was road construction. The noise of the construction covered the sound of the drill.
They must have seen the movie, too.
Come on.
If Kablooey's gonna rob the jewelry store, he needs to be in room 146.
Gah! The moose! The talking dog! Ah!
It's those two, all right. The sniffer is never wrong.
Yeah, but even if it is them, how do we know they're doing anything bad?
Look! Where are they going?
Shh. Let me help you, ma'am.
Hands off, you gutter snipe.
So well.
Why not?
Well, let's just say I've called them before. Monkeys are driving cars! They're gonna take over the planet and put all the people in cages! I'm guessing you could say I'm the boy who cried wolf.
Or monkey.
And asteroid. And blob. The police will say what they always say. I have an overactive imagination, and that I watch too many movies.
We'll have to stop those crooks on our own.
You're right, True. Man. Oh, man! Oh. I know exactly how to do it. I saw it in a movie. Come on!
So close.
Okay, here's how it works. Each of us has a role to play. Helen and the dogs will check into the hotel. You'll be our inside team.
The eagle has landed.
True will be the brainy guy. He'll keep an eye on all the players and tell us what to do.
The sensors are picking up vibrations coming from room 146. They've started drilling.
All clear. Here I go.
TD will be the guy who messes up and almost ruins the operation.
Hi. Just cleaning the floor. New system, see? No footprints.
Hey. Now don't let the kid out until the job's done.
Only it isn't really a mess up.
I'm in.
Stanley, you're on.
It's just a plot to distract them from this whole other operation going on behind their backs by me. Action guy! I'll do all the athletic stuff. Being athletic means that you're good at sporty things. Athletic people can run and do flips and help catch bad guys. And action guy is very athletic.
Nice. Check to make sure the coast is clear.
I'll drop out of the air shaft like a ninja, silently switch the bags, rescue TD. Huh?
on, hang on. How come all I get to do is tell you guys the coast is clear?
Yeah, why do you get to be action guy? I want to be action guy.
What about me? Don't I get to do anything?
Of course. You're the talking dog. You get to say something funny in the end.
Oh, okay, I'm cool with that.
But why can't I be action girl? Girls are athletic too, you know.
I should get to be action girl.
Hold it. You're all too scrawny to be action guy.
What do you mean, scrawny?
Scrawny means someone is weak and small.
I know what scrawny means. I'm just saying he's the scrawny one.
Oh, yeah? Well, tell me this. Can you climb walls?
Can you?
Yeah. Watch and learn, my friends. Watch and learn.
Stanley!
Are you okay?
Oh, did that hurt? It sure looked like it did.
I'm fine. Boy, being athletic is harder than it looks.
Hey, quiet. Listen.
What? I don't hear anything.
Exactly. There's no sound.
So?
The construction stopped. The jackhammers, too.
You mean?
Those crooks must have finished blasting through the wall.
They're probably grabbing the jewels right now.
Time is running out. We have to do something.
Maybe we do what we should have done in the first place. Call the police.
No, we find their getaway car.
Getaway car? It could be anywhere. How are we gonna find that?
I just did. The paint is still wet.
Let's call the police.
They'll never get here in time.
We have to keep those crooks here.
Piece of cake. Told you we didn't have to worry about those kids.
Going somewhere?
Whoa. Nice doggy.
Well, I'll be. How did you find out about this?
Stanley figured it out.
You? The space monkeys are invading, kid?
Yeah, I guess I was right this time.
Yeah!
But I couldn't have done it without Helen and Martha and TD and especially my man, True.
Man, True? Ah! Stanley!
What got into him?
I think I'm supposed to say something funny here.
Hello there. I'd like to talk to you about muscular and lanky. When someone is muscular, it means they're very strong and have lots of muscles. But when someone is lanky, that means they're tall and skinny. Animals can be muscular or lanky, too. Muscular. Lanky. Muscular. Lanky.
Of course you can be lanky and still have the most important muscle of all, your brain.
Technically, your brain is an organ, not a muscle.
Come on, True. Man, it's just a figure of speech. Work with me, will you?
Okay.
Muscular and lanky.
Yeah.
Two different words for two different body types.
Whoa.
Maybe you wouldn't trip so much if you stopped reading.
Stop reading? But this is Sporty Sport!
What's that?
The magazine that has everything you'd ever want to know about sports. As it says, a sport is a kind of game that has running, jumping, or throwing, hitting, or catching balls.
Whoa!
Are you reading too?
Nope, just tripped.
Hey, you guys want to have a race? Just for fun?
Well, we could race to my house. My dad made cookies.
Sure.
Okay.
Good.
Winner gets a giant glass of milk?
Deal.
Well, since I run faster than all of you, I'll just be the referee. Everybody ready? On your marks, get set, go!
Woohoo! I win! Thank you. First, I'd like to thank my swift feet.
What are swift feet?
Swift means really fast.
Oh, you do have swift feet.
But I also want to thank you guys. I couldn't have won this race if it wasn't for you being less swift than me. So this prize is for everyone. Who wants a sip?
That's okay.
I'm all right. victory!
What's this?
Oh, that's a trophy from soccer.
Yeah, we got those when we won the league championship.
Oh.
What's wrong?
Everybody else is always winning at sports and I've never won anything.
What are you talking about? I've never won anything.
You won the mini bowling tournament at field day.
Oh yeah, I was the mini bowling king.
Oh,
sorry.
TD and Alice win competitions all the time. And look at all the stuff that Helen's won.
Actually, a couple of those aren't even mine. Martha won best talking dog in some phony contest and Skits won a contest for catching flying objects.
Great! Even the dogs want more stuff than I have.
Hamburger. What?
But you're younger than we are. You've still got time to win lots of trophies.
Yeah, when I was your age, I didn't win anything.
What are you talking about? You always used to win at everything.
Shh. Kickball,
capture the flag, table tennis, not to mention...
Nothing, actually. Now that I think about it, maybe it was somebody else.
Okay, I think I'll go back to sleep now.
It's so unfair! Everyone in the world is winning stuff except for me!
Not everybody. My dad's never won a competition, and he's way older than all of us.
Hey! Guess what? My bowling league finished first! I just won a free pizza!
Ah!
Milo doesn't like pizza?
Club swinging. It's an Olympic sport. I'm gonna start training now so I can win a gold medal one day.
Club swinging? Are you sure that's an Olympic sport?
Yeah, take a look.
But did you read the part where it says club swinging hasn't been in the Olympics since 1932?
What? Ugh! I guess I missed that part. Great, I wasted my entire morning practicing.
Nah, it's not a waste if you're having fun.
But I wasn't having fun. I kind of hate club swinging.
But there are plenty of other sports you can practice and get good at, like basketball or golf or tennis.
Yeah, I tried all of those, and I didn't really like them.
Not even tennis? I love tennis. That's the one with the fuzzy yellow balls I like to chew on, right?
That's right. There must be a sport out there that you like.
What about competitive dog scratching? Is that a sport? It should be.
I don't think so. But there's an idea. You could make up your own sport. Somebody had to come up with all the sports that exist today.
Right! I can invent a sport that I like. And if I invent it, I can win at it. Thanks for coming to try Wagstaff City's newest sport, the Crab Walkstacle Course.
The what?
It's a race designed to test your stamina.
Stamina? Does that mean how fast you are?
No, your stamina is how long you can do something without getting tired. Everyone will have to crab walk to the park and back.
Huh?
Park? Milo, that's far.
Exactly, which is why stamina is more important than being fast. I've got lots of stamina from carrying a heavy backpack through my old neighborhood. The winner gets this really cool trophy I made from paper towel rolls. I've set up some obstacles to make it more challenging. Martha, do you mind being the referee again?
I would be happy to. Everybody ready? On your marks, get set, go! Congratulations!
Woohoo! I did it!
You got second place!
Congratulations, Alice. You've proved that you've got a lot of stamina.
I'm sorry. Should have let you win.
No way! If I'm gonna win at something, it has to be fair and square. Otherwise, it doesn't count. Just come back tomorrow. This new sport requires dexterity.
So what's the sport? All I see is a bunch of corn.
Exactly! It's ultimate corn shucking!
How is that different from regular corn shucking?
Well, mainly it has the word ultimate in it.
And what is dexterity?
Dexterity is how well you do stuff with your hands and fingers. Peeling the husks of corn takes dexterity. Everybody has 2 minutes to shuck as much corn as possible.
On your marks, get set, shuck!
Seven, eight. That's 8 for TD. So far, Alice is in the lead with 9. Let's count yours, Milo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Looks like Milo's the winner so far. Let's
see how many Truman has. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11!
Aw, man. Sorry for having so much dexterity. It must be from piano practice.
It's all right. You won fair and square, Truman. Congratulations.
So what happens to all of this corn?
My dad is having a barbecue this weekend. By the way, he says thanks. Since I didn't win at stamina or dexterity, I came out with a sport that tests coordination. Coordination means how well you can control the way your body moves.
Whoa! Whoa!
That was not very good coordination.
In this sport, you have to make 3 laps around the yard while tossing this ball from one hand to another.
Hey, I can do that!
But that's not all. You have to do it while balancing a book on your head. If you drop the book or your ball, you have to stop where you are and pick them up before you can move on.
On your marks, get set, bounce!
Whoa!
Ugh. Coordination and I don't get along so well.
That's okay. I'm actually having fun coming up with these new sports.
So you've tried stamina, dexterity, and coordination. What's next?
Oh, I know! Dog scratching. Dog scratching is a very important skill. Everyone will compete and I'll be the judge.
Oh, rub your belly if you want.
You could come up with a sport that has different parts to it. Like the triathlon. It's running, swimming, and cycling.
That's a good idea. You're good at so many things, and some of us are only good at one.
Okay, I'll try to think of something.
Next contestant, test your dexterity.
Okay, so this time I've come out with the ultimate sport that maybe I can finally win. And I hope I win because I'm running out of paper towel rolls to make trophies.
So, what's the new sport?
Well, instead of the triathlon, which has 3 parts, it's called the fiveathlon, which has 5 parts. First, you have to use your dexterity by filling 10 water balloons with a squeeze bottle. Then, in a test of coordination, you have to throw all 10 balloons at this giant poster of a monkey. Then you'll need to muster enough stamina to run around the yard 10 times while doing the chicken dance.
You mean the dance that goes like this? Na 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 na.
Exactly!
I love that dance!
After you've chicken danced around the yard, part 4 is to frog hop around the tree 3 times. Ribbit, ribbit. In part 5, you have to use your coordination and balance to cross the beam before finishing.
Awesome! Ready, set, go!
Congratulations!
And now you can't say you've never won anything.
Yeah, you won that one fair and square. And that was the hardest sport you came up with.
That was really fun. Want to do it again?
Sure, but I could go for a lemonade break first.
Anybody up for a competitive game of dog scratching? Who will it be? Who will be the champion? Anybody?
Dee Dee, what are you looking for?
It's the latest edition of Sporty Sports! And here it is!
That's me!
Wow!
Milo, Sporty Sport had a contest for inventing a new sport, and I entered the fiveathlon!
Seriously? That is so cool!
Now you've won 2 things, Milo!
You're on a roll!
Thanks, Dee Dee!
You're welcome! So, do you think the fiveathlon will catch on?
Nah.
We're working on our endurance.
Endurance is being able to do something for a really long time.
It takes a lot of endurance to run a long race.
Or to ride your bike up a really big hill.
So what kind of endurance are you working on?
Our standing and cheering endurance.
We're going to have to do a lot of standing and cheering during the Wagstaff City Marathon.
So we're training our legs.
Yeah! Woo!
But the marathon isn't for 3 months.
3 months? I don't know if I can wait that long.
Sure you can. We just have to work on our waiting endurance.
Come on, Martha. I'm not sure I can endure any more of this.
The square root of 100 equals 10.
Did you catch all the words?
Here they come again!
Your stamina is how long you can do something without getting tired.
Being athletic means that you're good at sporty things.
Dexterity is how well you do stuff with your hands and fingers.
A penny, a nickel, a quarter, a dime.
That's our show.
See you next time!
Yeah! Woo-hoo!
To dig up some more fun words and games, visit pbskids.org or check out your local library for the Martha Speaks books.